Worthy of all the glory. He is indeed worthy of all the honor. So just right now, for a few seconds, let's just lift up the name of Jesus. Let's magnify him. Let's bless him. Let's just call him for who he is, a great God. He is a healing God. He is an awesome God. He is a worthy God. Come on, just begin to bless him right where you are. Open up your mouths, lift your hands, clap your hands, stomp your feet, whatever it is you got to do. If you got to do a little dance, you ought to do your dance right now for Jesus. If he's been good to you this week, you ought to bless him. If he's been taking care of you through every situation that the devil tried to throw at you this week, you ought to lift his name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We lift your name, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hey. Come on, the Bible says if he be lifted up, he will draw all men to us. Hallelujah. Come on, you better bless the name of Jesus right now.
Great.
magnify him where you are. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There is nobody greater than our God. There is nobody wiser. Nobody stronger. Nobody greater. Nobody better than him. Nobody bigger. Come on, if you believe that this morning, you ought to bless him. You ought to stand and proclaim his name this morning. Come on, if you believe that when we call on the name of Jesus, things have to change, you ought to bless him right now. Flows to the lowest valley. I believe that the blood is still worth. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Oh, how we trust in Jesus.
Morning, everybody. Let's just take a minute right now to just pray for our brothers and sisters.
Nobody's stronger, so we call on the name of the Lord. Come on, I don't know if you thought your brother or your sister was gonna help you get through it, but only Jesus can. Call on the name of the Lord. Hey, come on, you don't need to put your faith in the doctors, but you need to call on the name of the Lord. Hey, oh, we will call on the name of the Lord. I believe that.
For there's something about Jesus. Jesus.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. God, we thank you. We give you glory. Give you honor. There is something about the name of Jesus. Father God, we come to you as humbly as we know how, giving you praise and giving you glory because you are the true and living God. We thank you because you kept us all year round. We thank you because you're still healing, you're still touching, you're still delivering, you're still making ways out of no ways. God, you are God and God alone. You are the great I am that I am. You are the strong tower that the righteous run into and they are saved. So, Father God, we bless you on this morning. We give you our offering of praise. We give you an offering of worship. We thank you, oh God, because you are good to us. Your mercy endures forever. God, we thank you. So on this morning, God, for each and every person that is listening to us on this morning, we ask you to break the chains, oh God. We ask you to transform the minds. We're asking you, oh God, to send a word that will pierce the hearts and the souls of your people, that will have them crying out for change, God, because only you can turn the hearts of man. So, Father God, we're asking you to save, set free, and deliver. We're asking you to restore. We're asking you to revive. We're asking you to reignite the body of Christ on this morning, oh God. Let the boxes, oh God, let the homes, oh God, be filled with your presence even now. We thank you in advance. We thank you for what you're doing. We thank you for what you're going to do, and we thank you for what you've already done, because if you did it before, God, you are able to do it again. So we thank you. We decree and declare that it is done, and we know it to be so. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Oh God, there's something
morning, everybody. Good morning. Welcome to Revival Time Evangelistic Center, where people just like you are connected to Christ. We thank you for joining us on this morning, and we just want to say hello from our pastor and our first lady, and we want to say thank you again for choosing to worship with us this morning. On this morning, we are here to celebrate a birthday. Happy birthday, Sister Diane Higgs. We thank you so much for joining us and being a part of our church. But most of all, we pray that you have a great year, that the will of God continue to manifest in your life, and that you are greatly encouraged that there is greater in store for you. So everybody send a text and heart this up and say happy birthday to Sister Diane Higgs. And now we're getting ready for encouraging words from our very own Sister Sharice. Enjoy.
Hello, Next Generation. Good morning. I just wanted to encourage you all, as well as encourage myself, to continue to be steadfast, continue to move, continue to seek the Lord. Do not give up. Continue to pray for our pastor. Continue to pray for our leaders. I know that right now is a tough, tough time, and I wish that I could be with you all, and I wish I could see you all. But as we continue to seek the Lord, and as we continue to go before the throne, as we continue to hold ourselves up on the word, I pray that you are continuing to stay healthy and to stay strong and stand firm on the word. Give up on yourself. Do not give up on our leaders. Do not give up on your church, and do not give up on your family. For everything that you do, those that are connected to you will also be blessed. So it's not just you that will be blessed, but your family will be blessed. Your friends will be blessed. Your co-workers will be blessed. So I pray that you do not give up. Do not, you will not lose. Lord is always on our side. He will always be by our side. I pray that as you those times that you cry at night, the times that you cry during the day when you feel alone, I pray that the Lord continues to comfort you. Allow the Holy Spirit to comfort you and be by your side. Remember that He will not leave our side. He will not leave you nor forsake you. He will not leave me nor forsake me. So I pray that you continue to Do what the Lord says. Continue to move when the Lord says move. Focus on Him. Get your strength through Him. For we will not move and we will not be successful in our own strength and our own will, but we will be successful and we will we get our strength through Him, for He is our Lord and Savior. We get our strength through Him. So I pray that you walk by faith and you not by sight. Continue to live with joy and peace. There should be no more sorrow. So I pray that you reach out to those that feel like they are left out. Reach out to those who feel like they are alone. Reach out to those who feel like there's nobody there. And if you feel like you there's nobody there, if you feel like you can't reach out to somebody, but you want someone to reach out to you, if you feel like nobody loves you, I'm here to tell you that I love you. I'm here to tell you that I'm there for you. I'm here to tell you that I think about you, and I will pray for you, and I will continue to pray for you. And I love you all with the love of Christ. I love my sisters and brothers. I miss my sisters and brothers. So next generation, I pray that you continue to be steadfast. Do not give up. Stand on the word. And I pray that you find joy and peace throughout any chaos that is going throughout your life. Yes.
Amen and amen. Thank you, Sister Charisse, for that encouraging word. I hope and pray that every heart, soul, and mind was uplifted on this Sunday morning. At this time, we would like to invite you to join us in our giving. 2 Corinthians 9 and 10 states, "Now he who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food will supply and will multiply your seed for sowing. He will increase the harvest of your righteousness." If you would like to give, there is a few ways you can give. You can visit revivaltimeministries.org and click giving. Or you can visit the RTEC app on your phone and give that way. Or you can text 84321 any amount. That is 84321 any amount. Just text it. Or you can stop by at 116 Florence Street between 12 and 2 p.m. today. 116 Florence Street between 12 and 2 p.m. At this time, take a moment and give.
I'll do anything that pleases you. You say,
whatever you
like to introduce none other but our own Minister Miguel Roman to give us a word from the Lord. But before he comes up, we will hear a selection from our own brother, Devante Narcisse. Let's give it up.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody magnify God in this place. Come on, we worship him in this place. How many know that God is the head of our situation? He's the lifter of our head. Come on, somebody magnify him. Wherever you're at, I dare you to lift up your sound and your praise unto him. The Bible said when the praises go up, surely the blessings come down. And how many know that God looks beyond our faults and saw our needs? Everything that we have gone through, we have did that was not pleasing in his sight. But we thank God for grace and mercy. Come on, somebody say, I thank God for grace and mercy. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody lift it up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody lift up your praise wherever you're at. Come on, lift up your sound. I believe God is hearing your sound and he's turning it to something. Come on, lift it up, Lord. Come on, lift it up in this place. Come on, God, we magnify you in this place. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord.
Amazing grace shall always be my song of praise. For it was grace that brought my liberty. Just why Christ came to love me so. He looked beyond all my faults and saw my needs.
Hallelujah.
Amazing shall always be my song of praise. For it was grace that brought my liberty. Just why Christ came to love me so. To Calvary, to view the cross where my Jesus died for me. How marvelous his grace is! Oh!
mountain, far from the peaceful shore. Very deeply staying within, seeking to rise no more. Save, am I?
Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, everybody. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. I stand here before you as humble as I can be. I am honored just to be standing here, to be able to bring the word of God. In first place, I'm going to pray. Father, we thank you. We thank you for this day. We thank you for the opportunity. We thank you for our daily bread of life. Father, I pray that your people's ears will be open so they can hear the word that you have for them. And their hearts open, Father, so they can receive your word. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. I want to start with a little testimony. A while back, I was prophesied, I was told that God was going to give me new blood. I didn't understand. I didn't know where it was going to. I had to take a trip to Philadelphia. But the week before Philadelphia, I got a colonoscopy. And they put two clips in my body. We went on the road to Philadelphia to take clothes to a ship that was going to Africa. On the way back, I felt like an upset stomach. My stomach was bothering me. And I said, I could make it the rest of the way. But after I finished saying that, I really got lightheaded. I started getting cold. I started getting dizzy. I saw an exit on the right-hand side, and I turned quick to get out of that exit. But little did I know that I went in between two speeding tractor trailers. Hallelujah. My God, my God, my God. I got out in part. But I was sitting there in my car. I was bleeding and bleeding and bleeding. Nothing but blood was coming out of my body. I was cold. I was sweating. I didn't know what was going on, but the blood kept on coming out of my body. Hallelujah. I died in my car. My God, thank you. I died in my car. And I saw this cloud before me. And I said to the cloud, Father, God, you said I shall live and not die. But after I said that, I woke up and Bishop was next to me. And I told her, pray for me. And she was already praying for me. Hallelujah. She said my name 7 times. And the 7th time, that's when my body shook. And I woke up. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I was taken to the hospital. Right away, they checked my blood level. And they said, no, we have to give this man blood. He ain't got no blood. So as they went to get the machines and get the blood, that took a minute, and the doctor said, let me check him one more time. And when he checked my blood level, it was full. God gave me new blood. They did not have to give me no transfusion. My God is mighty. Hallelujah. And I thank God for that. He spared my life and gave me the new blood that came directly from him. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. God is good. Let me tell you, God is good. Don't never doubt him. God is good. Hallelujah. Turn with me to the book of James, chapter 1, verse 12. I'll be reading from the Amplified version of the Bible. But first, I want to give honor to God. He's the head of my life. I'm going to give honor to my pastor, Stephen R. Williams, our First Lady, Denise Williams, and our matriarch of the church, Mother Dorothy Williams. And I want to give honor to everyone that is here where honor is due. And also I want to honor one person, a special person, and give her a tremendous honor because she is the love of my life, Pastor Rebecca Roman. Hallelujah. If you have the scripture, please say amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you. makes it happy. To be envied is the man who is patient under trials and stand up under temptation. For when he has stood the test, men approve, he will receive the victory, the crown of life, which God has promised to those who love him. Turn to your neighbor and repeat my message. Your promise is greater than your blessings. Hallelujah. You know, a lot of us along our journey, we start getting blessed and blessed and blessed and blessed. And we are happy with the blessings that we forget about the promise. Along that road, we get too comfortable and we get stuck with blessings. There are those who are determined to finish that journey, to get the promises of God, that along the way, they have to walk over or around those who stop just to stay blessed in that certain place. But those continue to get the promises of God. I know that we all face challenges. We all go through things. We can see that in the things we are facing right now, this COVID-19 crisis, racial tension and unrest, the people's hearts failing from all the stress, challenges, and more challenges. But we should take heart, because in the word of my pastor, God always ends on a positive. Amen? Here in this verse, the scripture in the first chapter of James, the writer is telling us that we are blessed, we are happy, and we are to be envied when we are patient under trials and stand up under temptation. I came by to let you know that it's a blessing to go through trials and temptations. Hallelujah. I know you may think that I've lost it, but in order for us to grow, we must go through some things. It is a blessing to go through. I know you may not like it, but it is a blessing to go through. But understand that when you go through trial, you must be patient and stand up under temptation. My God. A songwriter said, you can't hurry God. Oh, no. You just have to wait. You have to trust him and give him time, no matter how long it takes. You must be patient. Luke 21:19 says, in your patience possesses ye your soul. In other words, stand firm, don't give up, and you will win life. That is what James is saying in the other half, hallelujah, of the scripture. You see, he didn't just not stop at the blessing, because he also said that when you stood the test, there is the crown of life, which is promised from God. Your promise is greater than your blessing. Hallelujah. Hebrews 10:36 says, for ye have need of patience, that after ye have done the will of God, you may receive the promise. James 1:12 say, blessed is the man that endures, for when he has tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord hath promised to them that love him. Amen, 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 amen. Your promise is greater than your blessing. According to the dictionary, the meaning of the word blessing is the act of a person who is blessed. It is special favor, mercy, or benefits. In other words, because we are blessed with benefits from going through, and we go through because God's favor is in our lives. Hallelujah. The meaning of the word promise is a legally binding declaration that gives the person to whom it is made the right to expect or claim the performance or forbearance of a specific act. In other words, 2 Corinthians 1:20 says, for all the promises of God in him are yea, and in him, amen, unto the glory of God by us. This means it is a done deal. Amen. It is so. Your promise is greater than your blessing because amen is attached to the promise. The blessing is that you have been picked out to be picked on. The promise in 2 Chronicles 20:17, he shall not need to fight in this battle. Set yourself, stand ye still, and see the salvation of the Lord with you. The blessing that he brought out of that stressful mental situation that kept you up all night. The promise, Isaiah 26:3, thou will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on thee, because he trusted in thee. The blessing is I am standing here today, saved, sanctified, and filled with the precious gift of the Holy Ghost. The promise that was made to my mother in Isaiah 54:13, and all thy children shall be taught of the Lord, and great shall be the peace of thy children. So don't you worry about that hard-headed son. Don't you worry about that daughter that acts like if she lost her mind. The promise also came from Acts 2:17, and it shall come to pass in the last days, said God, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dreams. Before my mother died, she was praying, like, Lord, don't let my son die in sin before he had a chance to know you. It was a blessing that I did not die while I was in my sinful state. I was doing all kinds of drugs, anything I could get my hands on, doing anything I was big and bad enough to do. I walked around with a cold heart. Wherever I stand on the ground beneath my feet was frozen. But I had a praying mama. Hallelujah. She reminded God about his promise concerning her children. God. My mother did not get the opportunity to see me saved in her days. But I believe she saw it far off because she knew if God said it, that settles it, because he would do it. She knew that God was able to do exceedingly abundantly and above all that she could ask or think. She knew that the promise was greater than the blessing. Maybe there are some of you who are out there today who don't know about the promises of God. Hallelujah. Yes, it's a blessing that you are here today listening to this service, but you need to know what God promises you. God promises you in Romans 10:9, that if thou dost confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thy heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Amen. This is one of the greatest promises of God. It is such a great promise that John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, so whosoever believeth in him shall have everlasting life. Hallelujah. You don't have to go through a 12-step program, say 10 Hail Marys, or even get anyone else approval. All you have to do is confess that Jesus is Lord, believe that he was raised on the third day for your justification, and you will be saved. Hallelujah. It really doesn't matter who you are. God wants you to be saved. In 1 Timothy 2:4 say, who will have all men to be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth? I say you come into the knowledge of the truth. The truth is there is a heaven and there is a hell, and there is no place in between to those who think you live the good life or who think you are not so bad. One of these days we all have to spend eternity in one place or another. God promises you in the first chapter of Joshua, verse 9. Have not I commanded thee? Be strong and of good courage. Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed. For the Lord thy God is with thee whatsoever thou goest. You might have to walk through some tough times. And it is a blessing that you can go through. But more importantly, you are not walking alone, because he promised to go with you through your troubles, through your sickness, and through your pain. I'm coming to the end. Hallelujah. The good news is that for those who will trust him, God promises comfort, direction, forgiveness, peace, strength, guidance, resources, rest, protection, blessing, and answer to their prayers, and eternal life. If you put this all together, what it really means, your promise is greater than your blessing. Hallelujah. God bless you, everyone. Not sit down until I make this altar call. It's in my heart, it's in my spirit. For the altar is open. For those that are in need. For those who need guidance, and for those who need forgiveness. But most important, for those who want to accept Jesus as their Lord and Savior. Don't hesitate. Come quick. The door is open for you. Hallelujah. Don't worry about the one that stands next to you. It's all about you. It's not about him. Come and get your blessings from God. Come and receive the promises that he promised you. Hallelujah. Come. Don't hesitate. Come now. The time is right now, right now, right now, right now. Hallelujah. The pulpit is open. Come forward. Come. If you don't want to come forward, right there in your seat, you stay right here where you are. And ask the Lord right there and there, Father, in the name of Jesus, save me. I accept your Son, Jesus Christ, as my Lord and Savior. Hallelujah. Guide me now, Father, with your Holy Spirit. Give me the strength to move forward. Allow me always, Father, to walk with someone. And if I trip along the way, I got a hand. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You sing, hallelujah. During the hardest time in your life, when you walk, do not stand. You only saw one set of footprints. And you ask, God, where are you? I'm going through this, and all I see is one set of footprints. God said, my child. That I carry you, that you are going through what you are going through. That is why you see one set of people. What I'm trying to say here is that you are never alone. You are never alone. The Lord is always with you, to and from. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for this opportunity, Father, you have given to all those, Father, who open up their hearts and minds, Father, to accept your Son as their Lord and Savior. In the name of Jesus, Father, guide them always, give them strength. Let them know, Father, that even with all times to be hard, they will not be alone, that you will be there with them along their way to help them get through whatever it is they are going through. Hallelujah. I give you all the praises. I give you all the glory. In Jesus' name, amen.
guys for tuning in to our live broadcast today. I hope you guys were blessed. I want to thank Minister Miguel Roman for the word unto this morning. Your promise is greater than your blessing. That was an awesome word. We want to thank Sister Charisse with those encouraging words. And we want to thank our praise and worship team, Brother Devante and Brother McKenzie, for that wonderful worship this morning. If you guys want to continue to be a blessing, please give. We have multiple streams of giving. You could just click one of the links. If this is your first time worshiping with us online, we have a link, and we want to stay connected with you. So please click on the link and fill out the visitor's card. If you want to join our church and be a member of Revival Time, we're always welcoming anyone that wants to join the Revival Time family. There's a link for you as well, so you can fill out the link and you can stay connected. If you need a prayer, if you need someone to touch and agree with you in prayer, there's also a prayer cards in the link above, both on Facebook and YouTube. Please click those links, and one of our ministers will be in contact with you. Until next time, please be blessed. God bless.